I sat there for what seemed like hours, watching the clouds move across the sky, playing hide-and-seek with the sun. I felt the breeze on my skin and heard the wind blow the leaves on the trees. I felt my flesh burning in the sunlight to the point of discomfort just before the next volley of clouds ushered in relief. Blinking away the spots, I peered down at the back of my hands. Aged into diamonds, my flesh was no longer the soft, supple covering it once was. Scars of years past crisscrossing each other. When did this happen? When did I get old? Was it when I was shirking my responsibilities to make myself a better person? Was it when I was paying attention to what others thought of me and when I put their judgments of me above my own confidence? Or was it when I lost my soul and became merely human? I sat there for what seemed like hours, watching the moon trace its path across the sky. The breeze was replaced by silence and the animals of the night were all around me. I could feel them watching me, their eyes perfected to do so while I stumbled through the darkening night. Blinking away the past, I tried to find answers in the stars. Something to push me forward, push me to take the next great step in life. Scars of years past flooded through my mind, fighting to prioritize, fighting to be reopened. When did it happen? When did I get complicated? Was it when I was trying to be a grown-up before I was ready to understand what that entailed? Was it when I thought that pleasing others at my own sanity's expense was a worthy cause? Or was it when I finally understood that I am all that is to me, and that I am my own God? Am I? Am I my own deity? I'm limited in power and flawed by opinion. I'm also biased by experience and confused by trivialities. What was that other God to me? What good did that other God do for me? All through my life, I made my own decisions. I lied in my beds of my own making. I pulled myself up off the floor to fight another day. I found inspiration in the wind through the trees. I found sorrow in the pain of life. I discovered my true self underneath the trappings, and I was shaken to find naught but a little scared boy with a broken toy truck, wishing so much for there to be answers to why there are monsters in this world. I tried so hard to bring this child into the light so that he may find comfort in existence and wonder in living. I pointed to the stars at night, dreaming with him that one day we may visit and fly along the coronas and dive into the suns of distant worlds to see its central core. I spotted Mars and told him of all I had learned and that someday we would draw a mustache on the face and sled down Olympus Mons. We watched the ants as they went about their lives. Oblivious to us, I stopped him as he lifted his foot and reminded him of the chain of life, the glory of being alive, and that unnecessary wanton destruction wasn't to be condoned. We talked long hours throughout the day and the night, wishing to find answers for each other, me offering my answers from experience while he offered answers from his childlike imagination. I found hope in him that I forgot existed, but I felt that my answers simply caused him to shut down and shy away from talking more on life. We sat in silence for what seemed like days. I was afraid that I had scared him again, that my explanations of life were more than his mind could even fathom, that my experiences had jaded my world and my life within it. I was afraid he wouldn't ever regain the innocence and the hope and the courage in the face of life's monsters. I told him that there are bad things and that there are bad experiences, that life will never be as easy as I remember it being. Never again will there be a chance to shrug off responsibility for another bike ride around the block. Never again will there be the covers of protection between the sounds from under the bed and the shadows on the walls. Life is not beautiful. Tears welled up in his eyes as they did mine. I felt I was breaking him in twain, pulling him from what little comfort he knew in the dark. I felt like I was squeezing his heart into stopping. He sniffed and wiped away the tears rolling down his face. He breathed a shaky, deep breath and looked me in the eye. What are you telling me? That there's no point? That there's no escape from the wretched and the wicked and the pain? If that's what you've come here to tell me, why did you even try to find me? Why didn't you stay where you were, complacent, depressive, fake, mundane, and hopelessly average? If you are what I am supposed to be, I see no point in continuing. Wiping back the tears I shed as I listened to his words, I was struck with the hopelessness my life offered him. If I find no hope myself, how can I give hope to one so fragile and helpless? I have become fragile and helpless. Where is the strength I once had? Where was that man that should have grown from the fragile into the strong and from the helpless into the accomplished? Had I destroyed him somewhere between the hopeful child I once was and the tattered man I had become? Or was I just the scared little child, waiting to find a voice to shout out, a purpose beyond sycophantic musings, and a reason to fight against the monsters instead of cowering in fear of them? Which me is me? Listen, I told him. The wind still blows, if you silence your mind. The sun still shines behind the darkest of clouds. And the moon will illuminate your path when it seems only darkness and fear surround you. And if the moon fails you, the stars will sing for you and guide you through the night. Be you wicked or angelic, the life you live is yours and yours alone. Let no one tell you how you should be, and let yourself be free to experience and quick to wonder. Questioning yourself is never a bad thing, unless those questions hold you back and pull you under. Maybe there never will be a time when we can dance among the stars. Maybe there will never be a time when we can swim in Europa's seas. Maybe there will never be a time where you are perfect and change is not needed. Maybe life isn't beautiful. But living is. I sat there for hours. And then I picked up my broken toy truck and I walked back into the light.